गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास 10 स्टूडेंट. एज यू नो वी आर डूइंग लाइव चैप्टर रिविजन ऑफ लाइव चैप्टर विच इज इन योर एनुअल एग्जाम. सो आई एम कंटिन्यूइंग द रिविजन पार्ट 1 एंड 2 ऑलरेडी आई हैड गिवन टू यू. सो दिस इज द रिविजन पार्ट 3 एंड 4. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द क्वेश्चन आंसर सेशन. एन ऑब्जेक्ट इज प्लेस्ड एट अ डिस्टेंस ऑफ 20 सेंटीमीटर फ्रॉम कॉन्वेक्स मिरर एंड The image formed by the mirror is 10 centimeter away from the mirror. State the magnification and position and characteristics of the image. So here question given regarding convex mirror. What is the good thing about convex mirror? Because in convex mirror, wherever you are placing the object, always the size of the image will be diminished and upright. So for that reason, that is the one answer to already we are getting. If it is a convex mirror, then always the size of the object will be diminished and upright. Now how much diminished? See here given u equal to 20 centimeter means if it is your convex mirror, this is your convex mirror. So object placed suppose here. So this is the object distance 20 centimeter. So since it is my negative axis, so it is minus 20 centimeter. Now image formed somewhere that is 10 centimeter. Now it is a convex mirror means always image will be a virtual one. So virtual mirror one means somewhere here. So diminished image, suppose this is 10 centimeter. Now this is the positive direction means plus 10 centimeter. So magnification of the image will be m equal to minus v by u, that we know already. So minus v take common, minus 20, sorry, 10 by minus 20. So minus minus cancel out, 0 0 cancel out. Means whatever may be the object, image will be half, diminished by how much? Half of the object. Clear? So this thing done. Next question. State Snell's law of refraction. What are the constant in this law? Snell's law of refraction, as we know, what is Snell's law of refraction? Means if you are specifying or you are taking one specific color of light and two specific media, and then there is an oblique incidence. So color is specific, medium is specific. I am showing you, suppose this is the separation between two media. This is medium 1. And this is suppose medium 2. So this is the separation between two media. So if a ray obliquely incidence over here, so it will, if there is no separation medium, it should process like that. But since the medium is there, if this medium is denser medium, this medium is rarer medium, so this will bend towards the normal. And if this is the denser one, this is rarer one, that will move away from normal. So what is the law? First law is that the incident ray, refracted ray and normal drawn on the plane of incidence all lie in the same plane. And second one, the ratio of sine of angle of incidence to the sine of angle of refraction is always a constant quantity. That is the refracted index. Means sine I by sine r equal to mu of 1 to 2. This is the refractive index. Now another question with that is given is that is what is the constant? Constant or what? If I change the medium, the refractive index will be changed. So for Snell's law, medium should constant. Physical condition means outside physical condition should keep constant. Because if temperature change or other physical quantity has been changed, so the refractive index also will change, and color of light. If I am taking violet light, then refractive index of that two medium will be something. If I am having red light, then refractive index of that two medium will be something else. Why? Because depending on the color of light, the wavelength of the light will be different. Wavelength of the light different means speed of light will be different, and depending on the speed, the refractive index also will be different. Clear? So these are the constant in Snell's law. Now coming for the next question. Now my next question is that suppose speed of light in a medium is 2 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. Speed of light in a medium is 2 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. Calculate the refractive index of that medium. In my previous class I had discussed that refractive index of the medium is depends on the speed, means in air or vacuum what is the speed of the light and in that medium what is the speed of light. Now refractive index is the ratio of these two speed. So if the speed of light in medium is given 2 into 10 to the power 8, now speed of light in vacuum already we know. So if I do the ratio, I will get the speed of refractive index of that medium with respect to air or vacuum. So what I will do in this case, that is, in short I am writing RI, refractive index is equal to speed in air divided by speed in medium. So speed in air is 3 into 10 to the power 8 and speed in medium it is given in question, that is 2 into 10 to the power 8. So 10 to the power 8, 10 to the power 8 will be cancelled out. So refractive index mu 1 to 2, that will be 3 by 2 or rather 1.5. Yes, 1.5. So refractive index is 1.5. Now coming for the next question. Next question is that give a natural example of dispersion of light. You know all, that is dispersion of light is that when a polychromatic light entered in a medium, then sometimes it is seen that in that medium the light is, there is different velocity of light. Now if there is different velocity of light, so if it is a bunch of white light, it has 7 color, so 7 color proceeding in different direction. So what will happen, each individual color depending on their speed, they will deviate differently, they will change their path differently. Means what I am, my purpose of telling that, suppose this is the separation medium. Now white light falls here. Now this white light is a combination of what? Combination of 7 colors, but it together it seems to be white. Now within that we are having VIBG here, violet, indigo, blue, red, other thing. So that 7 color will be propagating in different direction. So after diffraction what I can see, there will be a spectrum of 7 color like this, clear? So this all 7 color will be splitted or separated from one another. So this all phenomena is called dispersion of light. Now tell me, now you know that is natural dispersion, what? Rainbow. We can see rainbow by natural dispersion. So natural dispersion example always will be rainbow. Next question, what will be the color of sky during daytime in moon? Means if in the daytime I am in moon, what is the color of the sky? Normally in earth, color of the sky is what? Blue. But in moon it is blue or something else. See, as we know that is air is a refracting medium or air is a highly dispersion medium. Means when white bunch of light comes to air, then it will split to 7 segment of colors. But we know moon has no atmosphere. So if a planet doesn't have, planet or satellite, whatever it may be, it doesn't have any atmosphere. So if it doesn't have any atmosphere, means what? It doesn't have any dispersive medium. So if dispersion medium is not there, so when sunlight falls on that moon, that is directly come to the moon surface, clear? Without any dispersion, so that spectrum will not be generated, means from sunlight we are not getting that band of lights, clear? So that's why since moon doesn't have any atmosphere, the color of the moon, sky of the moon, whatever may be the time, it is day or night, always it is black. Next question, What type of mirror is used in headlight of car and why? What is the purpose of headlight in a car? We know headlight provides an intense bunch of light. Means whatever light I am getting from my car, that should be highly magnified, highly first of all it should be very intense bright. Means what? If I want to get that type of light, I need what? 2, 3, 4 bulbs together it should glow. Just like Eden Garden, we are having that bunch of light in the field. But in a car, we can see in daytime, if you see the headlight of car, only one bulb is there. So actually what is happening in car, they are using concave mirror. Remember, why concave mirror they are using? Because it is a property of concave mirror ki always when parallel bunch of light falls on concave mirror, it will meet at focus. Clear? This phenomena is a vice versa matter. Means what? If parallel beam of light falls on mirror, that will comes to meet at focus. And similarly, if a bulb glows just at the focus of the mirror, that time we will get that parallel beam of light. That's why in headlight always use we are using concave mirror, and in the focus of that mirror we are placing our bulb. At the focus of the mirror we are placing our bulb. Clear?